I took my daughter Tanisha to the hospital because of a nosebleed. It's a private hospital that accepts welfare patients on a limited basis. They diagnosed her with lymphoma, a leukemia, a rare form of childhood cancer. Her doctor told me there's no cure or treatment for this type of cancer, that chemotherapy or radiation would only make her sicker and shorten her life. She told me I should take her home and give her as much love as I can before. Next day, the hospital administrator told me it was vital that Tanisha start treatment. I refused. Next thing I know, the police burst in the middle of the night and take my Tanisha away. They're starting chemotherapy on her.
Chris, this is Patricia. Listen, I just got a call about a welfare mother whose daughter was taken by the police. There's not enough for us here at the Examiner, but I thought you might like to dig around. Smells like your kind of a story.
Wasn't that your old editor?
Uh-huh. She calls every few months with these charity cases. Hey, make sure you wash that. You treat my place like a hotel.
No, you treat your place like a hotel. Mm. You are going to call this woman, aren't you? I mean, the mother she's talking about.
Nope.
Why not?
I'm out of that business.
How long have we been neighbors? You read 6 newspapers a day. You have the TV on 24 hours playing nothing but news. Chris, it's who you are. And not that trashy novel work you secretly do.
Hey, I thought you liked those.
I was being nice. Chris, this could be a second chance.
Nobody's gonna print it, JJ, okay? I mean, even if there was a story there, there's nothing I can do about it. My reputation as a journalist is shot. I'm damaged goods, all right?
I have a website to update. You know, I'm sure this woman will not think you're damaged goods. Patricia doesn't seem to think so. For what it's worth, neither do I.
Hey, I told you to clean this stuff up.
I don't know why she was taken. I just know she's better off getting the treatment she so desperately needs.
You mean the chemotherapy?
It is her only hope.
These reports from Europe say otherwise.
So now you're a doctor. If you must know, we're testing a new protocol that's very promising.
Oh, wait a minute. You're using her in a new drug trial?
You should learn to mind your own business.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking talking about the hospital and the girl. Stay away. You understand?
Jerks. Look, Alan, this is different. I need your help.
I thought you quit reporting.
This is serious. A little girl is going to die if we don't do something. Her mother's got nowhere else to turn.
Can I play on the swing?
Yes. Okay, I'm in.
Look, I wouldn't ask you this if it wasn't so serious.
Do you want me to sign it for you? I said I'm in.
Okay. Look, you know, this really means a lot to me, okay?
Yeah. I mean, look, I'm working here. Where do we start?
Oh, and there's just one other thing.
Really?
There's a couple of guys. They want me off the story big time.
Is that all?
Yeah. Well, no, I'm sort of persona non grata at the hospital.
Just like the old days, huh?
What do you got, JJ?
That disc you gave me?
Uh-huh.
It logged me straight into Navco Pharmaceuticals' own system. I gotta tell you, there's some weird stuff going on there, Chris. They're deleting records and press releases from all over the web.
Okay, listen. We need to get into the hospital and copy Tonisha's files before they go missing, too. Plus, somebody's got to check on her firsthand.
What do you have in mind?
What size jacket do you think Alan wears?
How big do they make them?